Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
somewhere. break every single rule. Will little brainy Bobby be the stockbroker man? Can he ever find a job that won't interfere with her tan? I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. Keep on thinking it's my time to fly. And this is how it feels.
Together, and as our lives change, come on.
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
somewhere. think about now? Can we survive it out there? Can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end, and suddenly it's like the women and men. Will the past be a shadow that will follow us around? Will these memories fade when I leave this town? I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. I keep on thinking it's our time to fly.
Take me to Funky Town. just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. A singer in a smoky room, a smell of wine and cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on and on and on.
Strangers waiting up and down the boulevard, their shadows searching in the night. Streetlights, people
Bye.
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
Funky Town?
Won't you take me to
about tomorrow like we think about now. Can we survive it out there? Can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end, and suddenly it's like the women and men. Will the past be a shadow that will follow us round? Will this memories fade when I leave this town? I keep thinking that it's not goodbye. I keep on thinking it's our time to fly.
Yeah. and soon to be graduate. Seniors and soon to be graduates, please be seated. If you feel comfortable with removing your mask, seniors, you may do so at this time. Good morning, everyone. I'm Mr. Dracy, the principal of Bishop Kearney. On behalf of the administration, faculty, and especially the class of 2021, it's my pleasure to welcome you to the 56th commencement exercise of Bishop Kearney High School. Before we begin the celebration, please listen to the following information from Frontier Field. Please sit where your ticket indicates. If you are out of your seat, Frontier Field asks that you put your mask on. Use the hand sanitizer stations throughout the facility. In case of an emergency, you will proceed to the nearest exit and leave the stadium. I'd like to introduce those folks joining me today. Sitting behind me is Bishop Kearney, Chairman of the Board of Trustees and graduate of the class of 1982, Mr. Richard Spencer. Assistant Principal, Mr. Keith Miller, who will also be our MC. Commencement speaker and Bishop Kearney graduate, Dr. Lyndon Gross. Now please help me welcome two students who will help us start our celebration with the invocation and the Pledge of Allegiance. Ladies and gentlemen, Josh Vogt and Camille Wright. Come on up, Josh and Camille.
Good morning, everyone. Please join us in a prayer to start this celebration. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear God, as we gather here today, we thank you for the opportunity to come together as brothers and sisters in Christ to celebrate the graduating class of 2021. Let the peace of your Son, Jesus Christ, flow through our hearts, and may his love unify all of us here today and all who are watching at home. Help us to realize that the past year was difficult, but your grace made it possible for us to be standing here today. Always remind us of all the blessings that you have bestowed on us during these past few years. You were there the moment we walked through the Bishop Kearney doors on the first day of school, and you were there on our final day. Inspire us to believe in the goodness of life even when faced with challenges and difficulties. Help us relish on these last few moments together as a class and surround us with your grace so that we may keep you close on our journey forward and continue to do all things well. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Blessed Edmund Rice, pray for us. Live Jesus in our heart forever.
At this time, can you all stand, remove your hats, and look at the flag? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Josh and Camille. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Keith Miller. I'm the assistant principal, and I just want to say before we get started, it has been a very difficult year. Obviously, our society, as well as our world in general, COVID being one of those, and the tensions that we feel among each other. I just want to congratulate all the people that sit before you and everyone that sits up in the stands, those at home. Thank you for your partnership in battling COVID and working together to create peace. For the blessing of the graduates, it's my pleasure to introduce to you one of the graduating students, Emily Teitler. Along with the Science Department Chair, Senior Class Advisor, Distinguished Faculty Member, Ms. Ellen Hansen, for the blessing of the graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, Emily Teitler and Ms. Hansen.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, dear God, thank you for this magnificent day. We are here to celebrate these outstanding men and women, and we ask your blessings on them as they journey forward to new places and experiences. We ask that they continue to shine in your light, that they take the opportunities that you provide to do the right thing, to be kind, to be generous, to be compassionate, to extend a helping hand and a warm smile, to think before they act, to follow the path that you have created for them with grace and dignity. Bless them as they go forward. Keep them safe in your loving embrace so that they feel empowered to challenge what is to create a better tomorrow. Keep their eyes on you, but set their hearts to the future and all that it holds and all that it can be for each of them. Guide them. Put a fire in their hearts with the confidence that they can achieve great things through you. Remind them of their foundation. It is strong and lasting. They have so many people standing with them to support them, encourage them, celebrate them, and cherish them. May they never forget where they came from, the roots of faith and justice with which they can do and be all things. Continue to guide and bless each of them and their families as they travel on to this next chapter. We thank you for all you have given us, all you do for us, and all you will continue to do in our lives.
We ask for a blessing upon the graduates of the class of 2021, for not only their endless efforts these past 4 years and their determination and diligence shown in the classroom, but for the essential values instilled in the hearts and minds of each individual here today. As we develop and move swiftly into the upcoming step in our life, we ask that God continue to watch over and bless us. We ask that He may shower us with love, support, and guidance. We ask for knowledge so we may discern the proper moral principles in our decisions. For integrity to provide us with consistency as we venture and explore. For wisdom as it aids us while we face unknown challenges. For honesty, that it will offer clarity and reveal our most true, authentic selves. For respect, to build our dignity and well-being while deepening our friendships, bonds, and relationships. For faith, so we can rely on that strength in times when we may doubt and struggle to find the solution. We ask for fearlessness so we can break away from comfort and be eager to take on a fresh day. For compassion to let us care and sympathize with others throughout our experiences. For humor that it can always brush away the negative of each day and keep our spirit confident. For perseverance so despite the battles of our days, we always are motivated and committed to bettering ourselves and others. For kindness, to be the beacon for each and every one of us, that it is always promising solace and serenity. We ask for growth, to redefine our personal development and be the necessary advancement to open us to opportunities. We ask for courage, to conquer our hesitation and instead take the crucial risks to achieve our dreams and goals. And we ask for love, to be the guide on our life journey, to encourage us, nourish us, reassure us, and inspire us as we waltz into our newest uncharted future. As high school comes to its close and the next step is eagerly awaiting us, bring joy and hopefulness into the hearts of these graduates to embolden them on their adventure called life. Blessed Edmund Rice, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever.
Good morning. I'm Tom O'Neill, Chief Executive Officer of Bishop Kearney High School. I certainly wish to congratulate the graduates today, but I also want to thank the parents, grandparents, guardians for entrusting your children to us. We're going to miss them all. It is now my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker. Dr. Lyndon Gross is a 1982 graduate of Bishop Kearney. After he left Kearney, he went on to earn his bachelor's degree at Cornell, where he was also awarded the coach's MVP award in his senior year in football. He didn't stop there, though. He then earned his medical degree and his PhD in molecular biology from State University of New York, where he graduated cum laude in the class of 1993. He completed his internship and orthopedic residency at the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center, and then completed a fellowship in sports medicine at the American Sports Medicine Institute under the world-renowned Dr. James Anders. He is a board-certified orthopedic surgeon at a prestigious private practice in St. Louis and specializes in sports medicine. He was selected by his peers as one of the top doctors in the nation. And here's the cool part. He's the team physician for the St. Louis Cardinals. Also, if you notice any shining and coming from his fingers, he's wearing a couple World Series rings today. But I also want to mention something about Dr. Gross. He exemplifies giving back. He's never forgotten where he came from. For the past several years, Dr. Gross has made significant donations to Bishop Kearney to support scholarships for students who come from a similar background and so that they can have the same start in life that he did. So ladies and gentlemen, it was great appreciation that he's here, and I also want to introduce today's speaker, Dr. Lyndon Gross.
Congratulations to the Bishop Kearney graduating class of 2021. For the last 4 years, you've sacrificed, overcome adversity, worked hard, and accomplished something you'll cherish for the rest of your lives. I am honored to be a graduate of Bishop Kearney and have this opportunity to come back to Rochester to speak to the future of our great nation. As I contemplated what I would say today, I took time to look at some of the greatest commencement speeches ever given. Steve Jobs, Natalie Portman, former President Barack Obama. And what I realized is I'm not one of those great speakers. So my strategy is a simple one: to be brief, be brilliant, and be gone. I want to start today by asking all the educators, administrators, family, and friends of the graduates to please stand and stay standing for me. As a proud parent of high school student myself, I have grown to have a deeper understanding of the commitment, resiliency, and occasionally the patience that is required to reach this milestone. To all of you, congratulations. In the words of the Hall of Fame coach, Dean Smith, when you make a basket, you point to the player who threw you the pass. This doesn't just apply to basketball, but to everything we do in life. No one makes it through life without an assist. As I look out at all of you, It reminds me that I appreciate this quote because success in life has always been a team game. To the graduates, the individuals standing before you have made many brilliant passes to get you to the basket today. Graduates, please join me with a round of applause for these heroes. Please be seated. When I think back to my graduation day from Bishop Kearney, one thing was certain. I wanted to be successful after I graduated in life. While the word success means different things to each of us, there are some common traits that are consistent. As part of my preparation for today's speech, I looked up traits to describe highly successful people. And these are five traits I thought were appropriate for today. Number one, successful people are positive. They choose to focus on the good in the world. Number two, successful people have integrity. They keep their word and treat people with kindness and respect no matter what. Number three, successful people are self-forgiving. They understand that they're going to make mistakes. And they choose to love and encourage themselves throughout it all. Number four, successful people are excuse-free. They take ownership of their mistakes, and they look for positive, productive solutions. And number five, successful people practice perseverance. Perseverance, what a powerful word. I believe that perseverance is the most critical trait for long-term success. Webster's Dictionary defines perseverance as a continued effort to do or achieve something despite difficulties, failure, or opposition. Perseverance, a continued effort to do or achieve something despite difficulties, failure, or opposition. In the past year, we've seen a true definition of perseverance on our planet as we recover from the COVID-19 pandemic. My prayers with any of you who have had challenges or difficulties due to this pandemic. Perseverance, what a powerful word. In my research, I found some interesting stories of individuals who demonstrated extraordinary perseverance and went on to change the world. Did you know that Thomas Edison, the inventor of the light bulb, failed somewhere between 1,000 to 10,000 times before achieving his goal? Most people would quit, but not Thomas Edison. Instead of quitting, Edison showed perseverance. He tried again until he achieved his goal. That kind of perseverance is nothing short of extraordinary. Then there was Walt Disney. Did you know that Walt Disney was fired from his first job because his boss didn't think he had enough imagination or creativity? One of the most creative minds in our world's history, who created the iconic Walt Disney theme parks, cartoons, and brand, was told he wasn't good enough. Through it all, Walt Disney showed perseverance and kept going despite other people's opinions or his personal failures. Perseverance, what a powerful word. While I didn't invent the light bulb or create an iconic amusement park, my story was a roller coaster ride full of ups and downs that required perseverance to achieve the success I enjoy today. To learn more about my journey, let me take you back in a time machine to 1978. My parents were both hardworking blue-collar citizens who never went to college, but had always dreamed of me one day getting a college degree. We lived in the city. I attended Frederick Douglass Junior High School in the Rochester School District. Like most of my friends, after graduation from eighth grade, everybody assumed my path to college was going through the Rochester School District by going to Benjamin Franklin High School. But what my parents didn't know is I had other ideas. My friends had told me about a really amazing private parochial school called Bishop Kearney. The more I learned about this school, the more I was sold on being a king. I truly believed that if I could get into that school, I'd be well on my way to going to a prestigious college in style. When my parents first heard about my big idea, the answer was a hard no. Never in a million years would they let me attend a school that they would have to spend their hard-earned money for a high school diploma that I could get for free. To convince my parents to change their minds was going to take perseverance. If going to Bishop Kearney is what I wanted to do, it was time for a continued effort to do or achieve something, despite difficulties, failure, or opposition. Perseverance, what a powerful word. So here's my big plan. If getting my parents to allow me to go to Bishop Kearney would require three big steps. Number one, passing the entrance exam. Number two, getting accepted. And number three, making enough money to pay for at least a portion of my tuition. It was time to get to work. Without my parents' knowledge, I took the entrance examination while simultaneously leaving a positive impression on all the teachers and administrators I met. I then worked extremely hard to find a job delivering newspapers that made me just enough money to pay for a portion of my tuition. Tests passed, accepted to school, money in hand, mission accomplished. I was ready to approach my parents. As a reminder, I was 14 years old, and I was just getting ready to tell my parents where I was going to go to high school. As you can imagine, this was going to be very difficult. I was in for some serious opposition. Although I failed miserably the first time, this time my continued effort won. They said yes, and I was a king. And the rest is history. During my next 4 years, Bishop Kearney changed how I saw the world and what my future could be. It showed me that if I used perseverance in the classroom, or anywhere else, I could achieve anything. After graduating from high school, I got accepted to Cornell University to pursue my education and play intercollegiate football. I quickly learned again that perseverance would once again be a big part of my life. From the beginning of my college experience, I knew I wanted to be a physician, but did not know and had no idea of the immense difficulties, opposition, or failures that were coming my way. Since I don't have hours to tell you about the many times I used perseverance along the way, here are a few of my biggest challenges that I had to overcome to date. During my sophomore year in football, I sustained a major injury that sidelined me for most of the season and made me think that I might have to quit something I loved. During my first 2 years in college, the increased academic load caused me to struggle, and I questioned if I'd even be able to get into medical school. During my orthopedic training, I was often required to stay up a mind-numbing 36 hours in a row, taking care of patients and writing notes, and I questioned if I ever get through my training. Once I became an orthopedic surgeon, I struggled hard to make my first orthopedic practice successful. I had many sleepless nights, wondering if I'd ever make my practice successful in St. Louis. In the end, perseverance paid off. I finished my football career being selected All-Ivy and receiving a coach's award for the MVP of the team. I graduated from medical school, cum laude, and completed a PhD in molecular biology. After successfully completing my orthopedic residency and sports medicine fellowship, I built a thriving orthopedic practice in St. Louis, where I currently serve as a team physician for the St. Louis Cardinals baseball team. As I said earlier, fun fact, For my contributions, they actually gave me 2 World Series rings, which I wear occasionally. It was quite a long way for a 14-year-old who had to convince his parents to allow him to go to Bishop Kearney. As I come to a close, I want to quickly share 5 keys in developing perseverance for yourself to all the graduates sitting here today. 1 is to have faith. The most influential and powerful support system in my life has been my faith in God. Always look to God, and He'll help you along your journey. 2 is to take care of your body. Health is your first wealth. You need to be healthy to have the energy to persevere through life's challenges. 3 is to connect with your goals daily. When things get tough, think about your final goal and it'll help you stay committed. 4 is to maintain optimism. A positive mind leads to positive words, positive actions, and positive outcomes. 5 is to celebrate the small wins. Each of you should be your number one fan and celebrate yourself often during the pursuit of your goals. This afternoon, I celebrate all of you, your family and friends. Celebrate all of you. Today is a big win. Never in the history of this planet has there been so much opportunity for you to do such amazing things. But in reality, it's not going to be easy. There are going to be some difficulties, failure, and opposition coming your way. If you have faith, take care of your body, stay connected to your goals, maintain optimism, celebrate the small wins. Perseverance and success will be yours. Congratulations again to the graduating class of Bishop Kearney 2021. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Gross. That will be the last time I set those up. So, Dr. Gross also doesn't know what my title is. I'm the biggest fan, right? Hey, who's an alum out here? Who's an alum? I was your fans too. Thank you all very much. It is now my pleasure to introduce our next speaker, the salutatorian of the class of 21. She is the daughter of William and Marguerite of Rochester, New York. And while at Bishop Kearney, this young lady has accomplished many things, such as earned a grade point average of 99.47%, has participated in many Bishop Kearney musicals and play, was a part of Jiva Theater's Stage Door Project production of Once. This past fall, she wrote an original play that was performed at BK. Her acting and writing has been recognized in several programs around the Rochester area. She's been involved in the House program as O'Day's lieutenant. She also co-organized and co-hosted a very successful pandemic talent show at the school this year. She played BK soccer. She enjoys filmmaking. She's going to be attending RIT in the fall of 2021, studying film and animation. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the salutatorian of the class of 2021, Miss Jessica Opet.
Thank you. Hello. This thing on? Sorry, my mom told me not to say that when I started my speech, so obviously I had to. Hi, everyone. I'm so honored to be speaking before all of you today, and to my graduates, I'm so proud to see you all graduating today. I may not be the funniest or the most outspoken or smartest person in class, apparently, but I hope that I can kind of help facilitate a little look into our past time at Bishop Kearney. So I'm going to start in the tradition of most salutatorians by beginning with a quote from an old white man. Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you might miss it. Although I can't match the indomitable wisdom of Ferris Bueller, I hope that I can help you guys kind of look back on your past 1 or 4 or 6 years at BK, or in my case, almost 7, because I actually happened to be one of the munchkins in the Wizard of Oz production about 7 years ago here. I don't know if anybody recognizes me. I was the short one. No, okay, that's all right. Well, what we're gonna start with is we're gonna do a little game with you graduates. So if all of you guys could raise your hand. It's okay, it's not a trick. Yeah, there's no winner or loser to this game. I just kind of want to show how far you've come. So if you were here last year, then you can keep your hand up. And if you weren't here, just put your hand down. Don't want to call out the newbies or anything. If you were here when we had our houses separated in lunchtime, keep your hand up. Oh my gosh, I remember that one. I was like, is this what it's like when the world ends? And then, of course, we had a global pandemic, and I was like, oh, that's what it's like when the world ends. If you were here the first year of our house system, keep your hand up. Okay. If you were here when Mr. Simone was principal, keep your hand up. Okay, we'll get a little trickier. If you were here when Mrs. Prinzing taught English, keep your hand up. Okay, and now this is a tricky one. If you were here before the hockey system, keep your hand up. And if you were here when Miss Kinley was the art teacher, keep your hand up. Wow. So I just kind of wanted to do this to show how much our school has changed while we've been here. You know, there's been some really awesome changes. There's been some less than ideal changes, but that's what happens. Places evolve. And we evolve with them. I'm sure you guys all know that the person you were in seventh grade is so different from the person you are now. But as cheesy as this sounds, it really can go by in a flash. You know, we always have those adults that tell us, oh, you better make the most out of your high school because it'll be done before you know it. And you think that you are making the most of it, but then you're here at graduation standing in front of a crowd of people who look vaguely like, and you're like, wow, we made it. We all made it. And the fact that each of us made it to today, just sheerly here, no matter what your GPA is, or how much you liked high school, or how popular you were, the fact that each of you is here right now is such a testament. But of course, you're gonna have those people who are always tell you, oh, I hope you enjoyed it because high school is the best years of your life. And that, quite frankly, is not true. Since when does high school have to be the pinnacle of our life? You know, it's not what they make it out to be in the movies. Not once was I serenaded with the boombox. That was for all you 80s teens out there. Yeah, thanks. It's really not what they make it out to be. And for some of us, quite frankly, it sucks at times. For some of us, it could suck for a lot of the time, and that's regardless of what school you go to. High school is just rough. So if you're one of those people, then don't get in that trap of guilt and regret and, oh, I should have gone to eighth grade homecoming, darn. Because our experience is individual, and it's unique for each of us. And of course, I don't want to suggest that, you know, high school was all bad, because it wasn't. And so I want to share a couple of the really happy memories I've had with you guys as a class. Because these are the ones that you're going to remember years down the line, that you're going to tell your kids and your grandkids or your neighbor or whoever. So, pardon the wind. Here are a couple of my favorite class memories that we have. So I remember seventh grade homecoming. I remember we had this big homecoming parade and there's music blasting in the gym and there's this cursed image of me and Anne-Marie doing the whip like really badly and somebody of course put that picture on the internet, so thank you, whoever that was, for putting that for all of humanity to see. I remember our really unnecessarily intense middle school dodgeball games. Like, there were waterworks people. It was bad. I remember our freshman retreat. We had nothing to do the first hour, so Nick Mott sang Let It Go for like 15 minutes straight. That's about exactly as fun as it sounds. I remember Mrs. Fowler in Latin class, like projectile launching foam balls at kids who fell asleep. Aim was impeccable, by the way. I remember the humans versus zombies and haunted hayride during Halloween. I remember the family feud and the big concerts during Christmas time. Oh, I remember junior year, poor Mrs. Hoffman, went into the teacher's conference room at the exact worst possible time. I can't explain it without it being a whole story, but let's just say it's not what you all are thinking, okay? And of course, who could forget the tragic spillage of Meemaw's ashes in AP Lit this year? I'm sorry, Mrs. Hoffman, I'm just so sorry. And the retreats this year, the totally amazing junior retreat, to the really fun freshman retreat, all of you guys who were involved, you guys did such an amazing job. And lastly, the past couple weeks, our Kairos, our senior retreat, our trip to Darien Lake, our Pace party, Jim the juggler, God bless you, Jim. All of the memories that I've spent with you guys these past couple weeks have been totally awesome. And some of you guys, you know, we go way back. Like, SKS gang, I've known you guys for a while. Where are you guys? And some of you I haven't even had a conversation with until like a week ago. But whenever the connection was made, I'm still glad it happened. Now I think that some thanks are in due. And I can't speak for all of the seniors, but I'm sure many of them share my sentiments. Teachers, thank you for being more than teachers, for being mentors, for being cheerleaders, organizers, for help shaping the way that we think, and for really watching us grow up into young adults. For parents and family, thank you for the totally innumerable ways that you support us every day, and not just the biological families, but the support systems that we have, the people who are always there with our backs, who make us feel loved, who make us feel seen. And for the parents who organized the killer Pace party, can I get a woo woo? It's okay, we'll work on that. And finally, to my classmates. I've watched you guys grow from super obnoxious seventh graders to slightly less obnoxious freshmen to actually really, really cool seniors. And I'm so glad that I got to meet every single one of you. You guys have your whole lives ahead of you, and this honestly is just the beginning. Oh, and before I end, I need to end with an inspirational quote, because I know Matt Tierney is gonna have like 500 in his speech, and I need to be able to say I one-upped him for once in my life. So, God gave us dogs because they, oh, I'm so sorry. I mixed up my pet funeral quotes with my graduation speech quotes. It happens to the best of us. Reach for the moon. Even if you miss, you'll land among the stars. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesse. Well done. She didn't even use the speech that I wrote for her. Hers was much better. All right. Now, I'd like to introduce our National Honor Society. This year, we had two co-presidents. As presidents, they were responsible for community service, which was difficult this year due to COVID-19. But together, they were able to organize several projects. Through their leadership, the NHS was able to organize food and clothing drives, essential items for those in need, and they were able to continue our collaboration efforts with the St. Anne's community. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome one of the National Honor Society presidents, Miss Anna Staten.
everyone. My name is Anna Staten, and I am the co-president of the Bishop Kearney chapter of the National Honor Society. I have the great privilege of standing in front of you all today and delivering this speech. Given the opportunity to reach this many people, I wanted to write this speech about something I care about and about something that affects all of us. Most times I've seen a president or leader stand up and give a speech, it has either been to address a problem or announce a victory. I am here now to address a problem. Climate change is defined as a change in global or regional climate patterns, in particular a change apparent from the mid to late 20th century onwards and attributed largely to the increased levels of atmospheric carbon dioxide produced by the use of fossil fuels. Now, I know a lot of you may be rolling your eyes right about now. Oh, here goes Anna again, always got something to say, has an opinion about everything. And yeah, you're absolutely right. I'm a strong, independent, confident, opinionated woman, and if that makes you uncomfortable, I'm glad. Anyway. Anyway, back to the topic at hand. Climate change, global warming, ocean levels rising, whole species going extinct at a rate unheard of ever before, natural disasters all over the news. We're all aware of these consequences, and we need to work harder to reverse them before it is too late. Climate change is the most pressing obstacle this generation will have to overcome. Unfortunately, it's all up to us. You can thank your parents and grandparents for that one. This generation could be Earth's miracle or its last breath. There are small changes we can make in our lives to lessen our carbon footprint, like recycling, composting, biking to school or work, eating less meat. But ultimately, it is the big corporations we need to convince. It is the leaders who we must force to acknowledge our presence. We must never be silenced. We can never become complacent. Many of us live in areas where climate change does not directly affect us. I don't live anywhere near a rising ocean, and if temperatures break any more records this summer, I can just turn up the AC. This makes climate change easily ignorable for those of us with this privilege. All I am asking of this generation and this Bishop Kearney class of 2021 is to always keep up the fight for your planet and for your home. Change the narrative surrounding climate change. Make it known to our leaders that we are angry and we want real change. Remember that this isn't just a speech about saving the planet from the girl with the shaved head. Climate change is the root of racial justice, gender justice, equity of resources, and overall, the human quality of life. If we want to see real change in our country and in our world, we must act like we've never acted before. Having known most of this class for the past 4 years, I am incredibly proud of the people we have grown into, and I know that if anyone can make our world a better place, it's us. Remember, we must not stay silent about this issue or any other threatening our lives. We have voices, and we must use them to defend the rights of ourselves, others, and the planet. As we embark on this journey, let us have the courage to change the things we can. Thank you.
Thank you, Anna. It is my pleasure now to introduce you to a trio of graduating Bishop Kearney singers along with Mr. Hoholik. If you direct your attention to the screens out there, please welcome Patricia De La Cruz, Tomas Hernandez, and Matthew Tierney.
Sky as we look. look upon. Jungle and fall, and the mountains should crumble to the sea. I won't cry, I won't cry, oh I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand, stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Whenever you're in trouble, won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand. Stand by me. Stand by me.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Rich Spencer. I'm the chair of the Board of Trustees at Bishop Kearney High School, and I want to welcome and congratulate everyone here. I'm here to deliver two brief messages. One is a sincere thank you to the staff on behalf of the Board of Trustees, and the second is a message from Steve Saluzzo, school president, who could not be here. But before I do that, I want to tell you about a family that I met last night. They traveled a long distance to be here, and that's Doug and Heather Rarick watching their daughter Sydney graduate. Doug and Heather, where are you? Right here, the Rarick's. From Houston, Texas, a round of applause for the Rarick's, everyone. They both are employees at NASA, and they do research in space exploration. And as I sat there last night talking to them, I said, Doug, Heather, must be difficult jobs. And they said, Rich, it is rocket science. Dr. Gross, I think I've been waiting my whole life to deliver that line. Just on behalf of the Board of Trustees, to all of our teachers, administrators, coaches, and staff, I often get calls from parents whose children attend other schools who have been closed this past year, from friends of mine who hear about schools that are closed, and yet our school remained operational. And they simply ask, how did you do it? And I said, don't ask me. You'd have to ask the teachers and the administrators and the coaches and all the staff who made that happen. And I simply do not have words that are adequate to express the Board of Trustees' appreciation for everything that all of you have done for our students. Thank you, sincerely. Steve Saluzzo had a death in his family, is unable to join us today. And those of you who have heard the graduation exercises before know that if Mr. Saluzzo was here, he'd give a speech followed by an Irish blessing. And I want to take a minute just to share with you that blessing on his behalf. May your troubles be less and your blessings be more, and nothing but happiness come through your door. Congratulations to the class of 2021. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Spencer. So, seniors and soon-to-be graduates, I am so glad that you were able to experience many or most of the traditional events that happened during the senior year, even if they had to be a little bit different. This last week, the last 2 weeks, the whole month of May were pretty darn busy. So your teachers and I had a lot of conversation about what we could do to make your senior year the best ever given the circumstances. And one of those decisions was to push the events back into the spring as long as we could in the hopes that some of the COVID restrictions would be lifted. That was great advice from your teachers. Towards the middle of May, at the beginning of May, and even right now, those restrictions were lifted quite a bit. You were able to have a ring ceremony. I attended your senior ball. You seemed to have a great time. You attended some pretty wonderful retreats. As Jesse mentioned, the Pace Party, you went to Darien Lake. After a very, very difficult junior year, I hope you enjoyed what Bishop Kearney was able to make happen, given all the rules that we had to follow. But as always, you, our seniors, really are the ones that made all of those events happen. Every morning we ask Blessed Edmund Rice to pray for us. In a year of so many struggles, I think it's important to keep in mind what the principles of an Edmund Rice education are. So listen to these. A Blessed Edmund Rice education evangelizes youth within the mission of the church, proclaims and witnesses to its Catholic identity. I like this next one. Stands in solidarity with those marginalized by poverty and injustice. Fosters and invigorates a community of faith. I like this next one quite a bit too. Celebrates the value and dignity of each person and nurtures the development of the whole person. Calls for collaboration and shared responsibility within its mission and pursues excellence in all endeavors. That's the one we probably know the most. Do all things well. This year, seniors, you really do embody all of those elements. I'm still fairly new to Kearney. I'm finishing my second year. Your teachers have told me all throughout this year that this senior class is really, really special. And I came to see this class in the exact same way. I know that you'll live your lives after high school just like you did at Bishop Kearney. So think about this. If everyone did the same, my guess is that the headlines we see on the multitude of news stations each evening would be quite a bit different. We're living in a time of great social turmoil. Can you imagine how much smoother things would be if everybody lived the mission of Blessed Edmund Rice like all of you do? How much smoother would the world situation be if everyone did live by that motto like you do, do all things well? I offer that you are already role models for each other and adults, and I'm looking forward to the time when you are in charge. I wish you the best as you move on in life. I've been doing this since 1985, and I want you to know that being your principal has been one of the top professional experiences of my entire life. So one more time, folks, Blessed Edmund Rice, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Geraci and Mr. Spencer. At this time, I would like to introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2021. He is the younger brother of Brian and David and the son of Paul and Christine of Rochester, New York. He entered BK in the seventh grade. While at Bishop Kearney, he has been part of the indoor and outdoor track teams, basketball, and captain of three soccer teams his junior and senior year. Along with being president of the National Honor Society and president of the Junior Honor Society and the National Honor Society, prefect and chaplain of House Castlebar, a core team leader of the retreat program, and involved in campus ministry, he's worked 2 years at Greenlight through BK's work-study program while also working at Wegman since his sophomore years. He's accomplished the rank of Eagle Scout in his junior year and became a certified EMT through MCC his senior year and has done over 250 community service hours. He's been part of the theater program, playing lead roles in the music the musicals, The Addams Family, Grease, Once, and Godspell. Through all of this, he has maintained a grade point average of 100.25. He's taken just about every AP class that we offer. In the fall, he'll be attending the University of Rochester, where he plans to double major in biomedical engineering and business management on a pre-med track. He truly does personify Bishop Kearney's motto, do all things well. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the class of 2021 valedictorian, Mr. Matthew Kearney.
Good morning, class of 2021! Faculty and staff and families. Now I know what you're all thinking. How can the man who danced to Frozen in his mom's dress for the talent show possibly be the valedictorian? Well, it happened. We sit here today to reminisce, and we sit here today to progress. We gather today on the cusp of boundless opportunities. But what makes today special? Today is the first day of the rest of our lives. However, so was yesterday, and the day before that, and so will be tomorrow, and the day after that. You decide what makes your days special, because you decide what you do during the course of your days. For the past 17 or 18 years, we've been somewhat bound to what we have to do and where we have to be. A course of action has been developed for us, and we have followed the agenda every day. We have had many opportunities to explore new things and enjoy ourselves. But now is our time to develop our own path, a path and journey that no one has ever traveled before, a unique expedition into the unknown. That is exactly what our future is, unknown and unpredictable. We all have ideas of how it will go and what we will do, but I ask you why? Why in the sense of what is your purpose in life? What is your passion? Nelson Mandela said, there is no passion to be found playing small and settling for a life that's less than the one you're capable of living. Dream big, because big dreams are alive. Denzel Washington said, but dreams without goals are just dreams. Be ambitious with your dreams and set high goals for yourself. Aim high, because anything less is better than if you didn't aim at all. It is important in life to realize you are the only person that can make a true difference in your life. So take the time to discover yourself. Be the difference in your own life so you can make a difference in someone else's life. After all, that is what life is about. In our world today, there is constant pressure to act a certain way, have things figured out, be successful, and always be perfect. However, the reality is, none of that actually matters. And putting sweeping generalizations on people can never be reliable. There are three words that, depending on the interpretation, can change a person's outlook on life. These words are success, happiness, and failure. These words are up for interpretation, and whomever is interpreting them determines their meaning. Success is a personal journey. It has no set definition, just a positive connotation. I would say success is where your passions and actions come together to create happiness, knowing that failure is right around the corner. I recently heard a definition of failing that has stuck with me. To fail is the first attempt in learning. Therefore, fail big and fail often. Failure is growth. Without failure, we wouldn't know what success is. I want to share 11 pieces of advice with you. First, show respect. In the past years, the insecurities of our nation have been illuminated by the injustice spread throughout the world. The root cause is the lack of respect. Respect differences. Respect yourself. And most importantly, respect every human life. Second, get excited from the little things in life. Allow your everyday events to excite you. Because if you wait for something grand or life-changing, it may never happen. Rather, enjoy all the little things in life because they will add up to something much greater over time. Third, never complain. Complaining is like being tied to a pole with shackles around your ankles. You are able to move around, but you will never break free to become your true self. Fourth, you always have a choice. You are the driver of your life. Everyone else is just another car on the road. Choose the harder path. In life, some things are simple and some things are complex. You have the ability to choose which way to go. And know that during that journey, you may decide to go another way. Fifth, be a lifelong learner. Someone once said, the capacity to learn is a gift. The ability to learn is a skill. The willingness to learn is a choice. Always be willing to learn. Don't be a know-it-all. You will never know everything. Accept it and move on. But with the power of will, determination, dedication, and discipline, you can truly encapsulate anything in the world. Sixth, we are all interconnected. Understand the power you have to impact others' lives every day, even if you don't notice it. So do good all the time and positively affect everyone you meet. Seventh, never give up. Doesn't matter how difficult the task is or how tired you are, keep moving forward. Eighth, live in absolutes, knowing there are exceptions. When you do things, do them to the best of your ability at all times. Ninth, have fun and enjoy your time. You're not truly living if you're not having a great time. Am I right? Our time is limited, so make sure you enjoy every second you have. Sometimes you have to make what you have to do what you want to do. Tenth, be uncomfortable. At some point in your life, you will be embarrassed. Embrace it and learn to love it. Uncomfort blossoms growth in your internal spirit. 11th, you can never say thank you enough. Always be grateful for what you have, because at any moment, everything could be taken away from you. Therefore, throughout your life, never forget to thank every person you encounter. Now the future is ours. We have been given a bountiful amount of opportunities to prepare ourselves. The unifying foundation of a Bishop Kearney education, experience, and community has developed each of us into the people we are today. And the people we are today will be sent out into the world tomorrow. We will be sent out to accomplish and achieve personal goals and aspirations. However, collectively, we will spread love, kindness, and peace through our inclusive roots that we have all acquired at Bishop Kearney. As we go forward, let us not forget what we have done here, the relationships we have kindled, and the experiences we have endured. This class of 2021 is unique, and I would argue one of the best to ever be at Kearney. From academics, the arts, and athletics, we have dominated it all. And we have led by example for generations to come. Let us continue. Let us understand this is the beginning of our lives. Every day we are presented with an empty canvas. What will you create? At the end of our lives, the pictures will accumulate into a beautiful mosaic that shows how we lived our lives. I want to leave you with a practical message from Denzel Washington. He said, "You'll never see a U-Haul behind a hearse. You'll never see a U-Haul behind a hearse because you can't take it with you. So put everything you've got into this life." If Bishop Kearney has taught us anything, it is the power of relationships. Focus on the bonds formed in your life rather than the material gains, because those are what truly makes life worth living. I want to thank Bishop Kearney for the motto, "Do all things well." In my life, it's no longer a motto. It is a lifestyle. Thank you to my teachers, for you have inspired and instilled in me a love to learn and showed vibrant passion. Thank you to my classmates for pushing me to be the best version of myself. Thank you to my friends, for I would not be where or who I am today without you. Lastly, thank you to my family for the support and the gift of love. Go now and live. Live ambitiously, live humbly, and live optimistically. I love you, and I will always be here for you. And always remember to do all things well. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Tierney. If you haven't registered to vote, he'll be running for office in 2028, so make sure you cast your vote for him. Great job. Every year, awards of distinction in various academic areas are bestowed upon Bishop Kearney graduates. It is a pleasure to present these special academic awards to the following students. The valedictorian of class of 2021, Mr. Matthew Tierney. The salutatorian of the class of 2021, Jessica Opet. The Founders Award is the most prestigious honor given to Bishop Kearney students. It is presented to male and female graduates who during their last 4 years have exemplified to the highest degree the ideals and spirit of Bishop Kearney High School. This year, the two students who have exemplified these ideals to the highest degree in the last 4 years are Casey O'Gara and Emily Teitler. The Scholar Athlete Award is presented to the student who has combined athletic ability and academic excellence this year. It's presented to two students, De'Asia Johnson and Ryan Lewis. The Blessed Teresa Gerhardinger Award for Service is presented to the student who dedicated themselves to our school and community during their years as a Bishop Kearney student. This year's recipient has completed more than 200 hours of service during the last 4 years, and the award goes to Alyssa Schaefer. The James E. Kearney Service Recognition Award is an award that is presented to students who have completed over 100 hours of service during their 4 years. The students have earned this award this year are Mojuma Molinja and Zoe Harith. The Campus Ministry Leadership Award is presented to students who have dedicated themselves to building and implementing our school's retreat program. Their unmatched leadership and social skills, paired with their determination and passion, has allowed all BK students to grow closer to God and to each other. This year's Campus Ministry Leadership Award goes to Evan Steve Lee and Timothy Halter. For distinction in the field of art, this award is presented to Natalia Colon. For distinction in the area of mathematics, Mary Kate O'Brien. For the distinction in the area of music, Patricia De La Cruz. For the distinction in the area of theater, Jessica Opet. For distinction in the study of religion, Anne Marie Hubble. The Brother Charles Crane Award for the distinction in science, Mr. Matthew Tierney. For the distinction in the area of social studies, Anna Staten. For the distinction in the study of Spanish, Anna Staten. I didn't want you to go back to your seat. Perfect. The Brother Paul M. Hannon Award for distinction in media arts, Tomas Hernandez. The Brother John Stewart Award for the Distinction in English, Jessica Opet. The New York State Scholarship of Academic Excellence is awarded to three recipients this year, Jessica Opet, Matt Tierney, and Joshua Vogt. One more round of applause for all our award winners. Mr. Spencer, Mr. O'Neill, Principal Geraci, and our guest, Dr. Lyndon Gross, it is now my honor as assistant principal to present these students who have successfully completed the diploma requirements of both New York State and Bishop Kearney High School and are therefore candidates for graduation. Sean Anderson. Riley Calhoun. Nicholas Chevenek. Natalia Colon. Patricia De La Cruz. Liberty Dodds. Shelby Deuster. Emily Finch. Mariana Freeman. Jaden Grayson. Timothy Halter. Zoe Harith. Tomas Hernandez. Anne-Marie Hubble. Deja Johnson. Jalik Johnson. Lena Kalupski. Mary Rachel Linnaeus. Ryan Lewis. Patrick Martin. Ryan Martin. Heather McAvoy. Leanna McGee. Reagan Miller. Mwajuma Malenja. Benjamin Mulford. Nicholas Mulford. JC Muto. Taylor Norris. Mary Kate O'Brien. Casey O'Gara. Jessica Opet. Samuel Plain. Sydney Rarick. Ella Ridge. Wilfredo Sanchez. Alyssa Schaefer. Ayana Scott. Anna Staten. Evan Steveley. Jordan Stewart. Taya Thornton. Matthew Tierney. Emily Teitler. Joshua Vogt. Carlos Washington. Sanaya Wilson. Haley Wynn. Camille Wright. While we wait for the remaining graduates back to the seat, could we have a big round of applause to Mr. Dan Mason, Frontier Field staff, everybody that helped make this possible. Could we give him a round of applause, please? Graduates, please stand. Please move your tassels as an indication that you are now graduated from Bishop Kearney High School. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2021.
Matt Tierney has got to go president.
All All right, thank you everybody who joined us here today. Please join your student on the concourse near the main gate for the recessional. Thank you all for coming. May God bless you. Processional music, Jessica and Shelby, lead us out, please.
Thank you.